it's not just me and Sonia and himself, Mr. Eamonn, bringing the Day of Promise to you. We're going to be seeing loads and loads of stars and finding out what their promises are, because we can't ask you to make a promise unless we make one ourselves. So let's start at the very top with a man who makes the headlines every night, literally, Sir Trevor MacDonald.
And now for something I'd particularly like you to take notice of. Thousands of children still die every year from leukemia, even though it can often be cured with a bone marrow transplant. We have a short report coming up, but first, my promise is to campaign to persuade people, especially from the ethnic minorities, to register as bone marrow donors, and perhaps one day save a life. Jason Stevens is 11 years old. Like so many boys of his age, he loves football, and one day hopes to become a professional. But Jason might never see his dream come true. Last June, he was diagnosed with a life-threatening disease, leukemia.
When I first realised that he wasn't well, when he started telling me that he feels a bit tired, that's not like him. You know, he's full of beans normally and wanting to go out and play.
Jason was given chemotherapy. After five long courses, he's now in remission. Unfortunately, Jason's leukemia can only be cured with a bone marrow transplant. His chances of survival now depend on finding a compatible donor, which is much more likely to be from his same ethnic group. Sadly, there's a real shortage of volunteers.
Well, first of all the family, his brothers, my husband and myself, we had a test done to see if we were a match for Jason, but none of us has been a match.
The Afro-Caribbean Leukemia Trust is a voluntary organization that runs regular clinics around the country to try and find more donors.
We go out and raise awareness of leukemia among the African-Caribbean mixed race community to try and get the numbers up on the register. When we started, there were 550 people of African-Caribbean mixed race on the register. We've now got 13,000, which is good, but not good enough.
To become a donor, volunteers like Julius Francis, the heavyweight boxer, need only give a small blood sample.
It's only a little pinprick, you could be saving a life.
They must also be between 18 and 40 and in good health. The donor's details are then passed on to the Anthony Nolan Trust, one of the largest official registers of potential bone marrow donors in the world, with nearly 300,000 names on their database.
Donating bone marrow is not a complicated procedure. It's under general anesthetic, and there's no incision at all.
In the morning, they took me, count to 10, general anesthetic, went to sleep. When I woke up, it was done. I would do it again, you know, if I had the chance. If you can help to save someone's life.
Living with the constant fear of a relapse, Jason tries to lead a normal existence as the search continues for a life-saving donor. Bone marrow transplants are particularly successful in children, and there can't be many people who wouldn't want to save a child's life. So whoever you are, but particularly if you're from an ethnic minority, please make it your promise to register as a donor.
Thank you very much, Trevor. Now, you might want to make that your promise. If so, don't muck around, ring right now. The number is at the bottom of the screen. We've had a couple in here, one from the Brown family from Reading. Their promise as a family is to learn emergency resuscitation, as two members of the family have heart conditions. We've also had Cheeky Ross McWilliams from Berkshire, who promises not to tell anyone about his mum's grey hair. Thank you very much for that, Ross. Now, as you know, ITV is one big happy family made up of 16 different regions, and it's only right that all of those companies have made promises too, and here are some of them.
3, 2, 1, go!
Hello, I'm Jason Beresford from Tyne Tees Television, up here in the northeast of England, and we've promised to help improve numeracy levels at schools right across the region.
That is exactly 10 seconds.
That is 1/6 of a minute.
Here in the Border Television region, our promise was to promote better health. Since October, we've taken a look at a whole host of sensitive and topical issues, from organ transplants to child surveys and the changing face of family care in North Cumbria. We hope we've helped our viewers feel healthier.
It's easy to feel lost in London, especially if you're young, you know, that nobody listens to you. But it doesn't have to be like that. London Weekend Television is running a project called Our London. The idea is to help youngsters send a message to the new mayor. And the idea is that they should use the form of art, like here on the Underground, perhaps, by designing a poster. And that's LWT's pledge for ITV's Year of Promise, to help youngsters build their confidence, their skills, and their experience, and to tell the new mayor what matters to them about their city.
So you can make a corporate promise, you can nag your boss to make one on behalf of the company, or you can make an individual promise yourself, or even as a family. These phones are absolutely red hot. If you want to phone in, you might be lucky enough to get through to S Club 7, to Sally Gray, to Graham from Home and Away, to Paul here from the Full Monty. Who knows who may answer the phone? Well, last year we commissioned an opinion poll to find out which things we, the great British public, most wanted to change. Things like road safety, childcare, security, litter, anything and everything. And we then went to some of the best known advertising agencies in the country, and they promised to use their creative skills, which normally cost a double of a lot of money, to make some short films to promote some of the smaller charities who work in these particular areas where you want to see things changed. So here are two of those films.
I'm Amy Lawson from the advertising agency WCRS. Our promise to Let's Link was to make this film, and here are the people who helped to make it happen.
I'm decorating my living room.
I'm teaching my daughter to read.
I'm walking my dogs.
I'm building my website.
I'm fixing my car.
Let's Link enables you to trade the skills you have for the ones you need, and build a better community while you're at it. Let's Link taps a wealth of talent.
Hello. We're from Polter Partners, and our promise was to make a film for PlantLife. This is it.
I know a bank where the wild thyme blows, where oxlips and the nodding violet grows, quite over canopied with luscious woodbine, with sweet musk roses and with eglantine. There sleeps Titania, some time of the night, lulled by these flowers in dances of delight. And there the snake sheds her enameled skin, weed wide enough to wrap a fairy in. You can still see what Shakespeare saw in our meadows, hedgerows, and woodlands. Make a promise to make the time to look.
These charities can make a real difference with your help. They're only little charities, so if you'd like more information about them or anything else to do with the Year of Promise, you can go to Teletext page 108 or to our website, www.itv.yearofpromise.co.uk, or just ring this number and ask for our fact sheet, which covers the lot. Now, this Day of Promise will be on your screens until midnight tonight. There is no escape from us. At 3 o'clock, we'll be bringing you David Ginola's promise. That'll be very nice. Then at 6, we have Des O'Connor, Angela Rippon and Lisa Riley from Emmerdale, followed at 8 o'clock by promises from Brian Connolly, Harry Hill and Chris Tarrant, and lots and lots and lots of other people. And we'll also be visiting the Freeman Hospital in Newcastle, where 6-year-old Sally Slater is recovering from her heart transplant. Have you thought of your promise yet? Here are some more ideas.
I'm Bridie Pollard, Head of Public Relations at Avon. Our promise is to raise a further £650,000 this year for the research charity Breakthrough Breast Cancer.
And that's our promise!
My promise is to spend more time with my children.
My name is Alison Bourke from Nottingham. These are my three children, Matthew, Natalie and Emily.
All my children are autistic, and my promise is to raise £90,000 for special treatment to help them.
Well, great though that story is, the sad fact is that Sally is only alive because someone else died and she received the heart transplant. But there are other ways to save life which don't involve tragedy. You can see the blood transfusion unit here. Michael Piccirilli.
Yes,
Piccirilli.
Sir. Close enough.
It's like something you put on a sandwich, isn't it? But
yeah.
Michael, you'll recognise as James from Home and Away. And this is a big day for you, Michael, in the Day of Promise. Now tell everybody what you have decided to do.
Yes, my promise is to donate blood. Yes.
And you've never done it before?
I've never done it before.
Are you quite squeamish about it?
Well, I don't know.
You're going to find out. I don't think there's too much to worry
fine.
About.
It will be
important.
Fine.
I mean, it has got home to you how important it is.
Oh, definitely. And actually, once you donate blood, it takes less than an hour.
Yeah.
They require 450 mils, which is a bit under a pint.
And they need 3 million of those donations a year, so they do. But they don't need them all at once. This has got to be done regularly and staged throughout the year. So if you just walk this way here, we've got some nice people who may just look after you in here, inside the blood mobile. And look who we've got in here. I am not going to attempt to tell the difference between the twins, Adrian and Neil. You could be lying to me and I wouldn't know. Yes.
Adrian.
Yeah. Have you done this before? From Better Homes, incidentally.
Oh, I'm a regular visitor to the blood. No, actually, this is my first time, Eamonn. So, but I think it's very important to make sure that we give blood. So Neil's done it before, and he brought me along. We're going to give blood and make it a regular thing.
And we can actually see.
We can, I know.
There it is.
I'm trying to keep my speech intact.
How much have you to give?
Oh, a couple of pints. No, I think it's just the one, isn't it?
One pint, under a pint.
Oh, is it under a pint,
under
is it?
A pint. Oh, that's good. Oh, don't worry. Well, Neil, how does it feel?
It's very, very easy thing to do. It's totally painless, and it's quite relaxing, actually.
I'm sure you've spilt a few bits of blood
in
your Holmes programme.
Absolutely, yeah. I was getting hit with hammers and bricks falling on your feet and damaging knuckles and bits and pieces. So actually to do this is relatively easy.
Your hair is off. Hey, and well done. Lovely staff here from the blood transfusion unit. So we're going to get... You are. What are you... No, you are. You really are. Very, very nice people. Now, I've got a map. Will you look after this man for me here? Michael, go in. You're in safe hands. Go on. It doesn't hurt a bit. Right. We're now going to go back to somebody you know quite well, Miss Vorderman.
Yeah, I do know them very well. They are, of course, my boys, Adrian, Neil, Raymond, from Better Homes, which is back on next Monday. Now, this, of course, is ITV's Year of Promise, and some people have already fulfilled promises made months ago. Last October, we featured Charlotte Robbins from Bedlinog in South Wales, who made what, by any standards, was a huge and an ambitious promise.
I promised to turn this village around, to beat depression, to beat the drugs, and to beat the crime, and to make it a better place and a better future for this village.
Charlotte's plan to get young people off the streets was to set up a cybercafe in Bedlinog, like the one she helped establish in Aberfan. That was a huge promise, and not an easy thing to achieve. Yet 6 months later, Charlotte's dream is coming true. The local Merthyr Tydfil Council wanted to turn this disused school into a community centre. When their policy manager Gary Thomas saw Charlotte on the Year of Promise launch show, he realised they could join forces.
Through Charlotte, we've come up now with the idea of providing a cyber cafe, a cybernet facility within this school.
Charlotte's promise also inspired a major computer company, Sun Systems, to donate all the computers they needed for the cafe.
Well, the main aim within the community is to raise the confidence again, to give them a lot more self-esteem and a lot of hope for the future.
Charlotte's promise has helped to open up a whole new horizon for the young people of Bedlinog.
I know, I can't believe it myself. I'm just so happy about it. It's really good.
Yeah, Charlotte did do it. You can do it too. You can make your promise. You can register it online on 08457 555 300. Now, as I said, some of Britain's top ad agencies have made films to promote some smaller charities who deal with things that you have told us you care about. For example,
the following film is the result of a promise that our agency, Euro-RSCG Win at Gosper, made to the Foyer Federation, a charity which helps young homeless people all over the country.
This is Kerry. When she was 16, things got bad. She was kicked out of her home by her mom's latest boyfriend. with no one to run to, she ran away. She soon realised big cities are empty places, full of people. A year later, and Kerry's still in London. She's making good money now, seeing up to 5 clients a day. Her prices depend on whatever they want her to do.
Thank you.
Thankfully, Kerry was put in touch with a foyer. Here, she found a place to stay with access to training and employment. It was all the help she needed to help herself.
We at Space City gift this film to Common Ground with our very best wishes.
Surviving in the 21st century isn't easy. It's only too easy to overlook the richness of life right under our noses. Natural things, cultural things, that give us a sense of identity and belonging. And because we get distracted, why should our kids miss out? Common Ground offers ideas, information and inspiration for people and local communities to refocus on real values and enrich their lives. Simple ideas or visionary projects. With a little help, we can turn each other's dreams into reality. Revive a local village custom. Revitalise your local stream or canal. Get together, mark an event in the ethnic calendar which celebrates nature. Build window boxes for your street or school. Rally round and get involved in a local development plan. Transform inner city waste ground into a community asset. Respect history, but relish the future. A colourful Common Ground poster will start you thinking about ways to discover and celebrate local distinctiveness.
And you know what? Those films make such a difference to small charities because every little bit makes a huge difference to them.
Yeah, it helps us all discover them. And those advertising agencies and the actors involved and whatever, giving up their time.
Because, of course,
free.
That's their promise, isn't it?
That is their promise. Which but, you know, wouldn't it be nice if ITV promised to show those over the course of the year so we're all aware?
Oh,
so
yeah.
Somebody at an ITV company, phone us and make that your promise.
Yes, well, let's see if they do.
That'll get me sacked, but anyway.
Will. Off you go, Mr. Eamonn Holmes. And if you'd like more information about any of the charities in the films that you're going to see, or any of the ones that you have seen, or anything at all to do with the Year of Promise, go to Teletext page 108 now, or our website,
www.itv.yearofpromise.co.uk.
No, simple. You missed a dot there. itv.yearofpromise.co.uk. But if you want to know how to register your promise, don't go away.
You can register your promise in one of three ways. By phone, now, on 0845 755 300. Online now, at www.itv.yearofpromise.co.uk. Or on a registration form from any branch of Barclays, Iceland, Dixon's, PC World, The Link, at Jakarta, or BP.
But that's not the only chance you have of making your mark in history. For £25, you can have your name, your promise, displayed at one of nearly 100 landmark promise sites across the country, as now being pointed out by my beautiful assistant.
Perfect. Let's have a look at where they are, shall we? There are sites in lots of fascinating... I'm not telling you that. It's good. Lots of fascinating places. Give you a taste of what's on offer. We sent Sonia Saul all around the country. Here she is now. Where are you?
She's in Warrington.
So we are in the new millennium. This is your chance to make your mark in history. Now, S Club 7 are with us. How are the phones going?
Brilliant. Really well.
You've got loads and loads of phone calls, haven't you? So if you want to speak to them, who knows, you might be lucky and get through to the phones on them. And over here, we have Graham from Home and Away. We have Sally Gray. We have Paul. How is it going?
I tell you what, these calls are flooding in. They're awesome.
Yeah, they sure are. Yep, got calls from everywhere.
Thanks for your call.
Excellent. Excellent. Well, keep answering. Keep answering. It's just incredible.
It is incredible. It's ITV's Day of Promise. Please be part of it. Give us a ring. We'll be back after the ITN news and make a promise, just like ITN.
Here it is.
Hello, I'm Dermot Murnaghan from ITN, and we promise to help school children understand how news programmes are made and why news is important to everyone. And we'll be doing that through our new school's website at itn.co.uk, where you can select top stories and make your own news bulletins. And our team of award-winning journalists will be making special visits to schools across the country.